In this video, we will see how to change the background on Blender. And we will try to make this background more of a sky full of stars. Or we'll see how it looks at night. I placed a planet in the middle so that I could get a more realistic scenario. In this way, you can use this feature in your planetary scenarios, space themed scenarios, or science fiction themed project. First of all, the sky is colored black. So we need to set the background to be completely black. Let's click on the world icon in the icons on the right. Go to world properties and set the color to be completely black. If it doesn't look like this for you, it is necessary to change the above view modes. It might look like this. It may appear as gray. In this case, you need to switch to render view. And let's remove the grids and lines here. For this, let's click on the overlay icon to remove them. Thus, we have a clean background of the sky. Currently, the background appears as black. We will add stars to this background. I right click on this line and choose vertical split, because I want to split it vertically. By clicking anywhere on the scene, I split the screen into two. When I select shader from the options on the left, let's narrow the right side. This way, the material screen will open. By default, you will normally see these two on the right. I also want to add a planet image, so the left side panel is also open. But we choose world instead of object, because we will change the background, not the objects on the scene. When we select the world option, the same panels will appear for you and me. Now, we will add new features here. I click add in the menu above. I select the Voronoi texture option under texture and edit here. This is a feature where we can create patterns like cells. We will use this as the sky. And I'm dragging the distance of this property to the color of the background. They are already starting to look like cells. When I move around, we see that the background also moves. When I increase the size part, you will see that the dots in the background become smaller. The more I increase it, the smaller it gets. This will bring us much closer to the stellar view. Let it be a straight number. I'm doing 75 here. Now you need to add a map range. We will do this with the map range option under Add Converter. I'm placing it right in between. Here are the options we need to change with this feature. The minimum value needs to be higher than the maximum value. For example, I'm setting the maximum to 0. The background has turned completely black. I also change it to 0.1 and the stars become a little more distinct. But they are still the same size. I change the F1 option on the Voronoi texture to Smooth F1. Differentiate the sizing of the stars as well. When this is changed, we will see large and small stars. When I looked around, it started to feel like we were in the universe. I increase the scale value a little more. I'm doing 200. The stars got much smaller because we increased the scale value. You can arrange it according to your own project. At this point, when I decrease the minimum value, I make the value 1 to 0.5. And when I control it in this way, we can see that it looks much more like the universe. You can also increase the maximum value to increase the visibility and brightness of the stars. For example, I set the to maximum value to 2, notice to the right, the stars seem to be more numerous. If you look at the scene full screen, it looks like there really are stars like this. As I said, you can change the brightness, number and size of these stars according to your own project. In this way, we can create sky stars, 360-degree star backgrounds by using the nodes for the background and changing their values. That's all for this video. In this video, I showed you how to quickly create a sky. If this video helped you out, don't forget to like, share and subscribe. I'll see you in the next video.